Yeah, wow, yeah.
Well, let's get into it.
What did you think
it,
about the,
what's the stuff that you're talking
the response
about?
Today from the fans, from the crowd, from the media members?
Huh?
The turnout was huge.
Oh, yeah, I love it, man. Shout out to Ellie. That's who I fuck with. I fuck with Ellie Setback.
Adrien, you mentioned this has been the best camp of your life. What's made it the best camp of your life?
What'd
so
you
far?
Say, Ellie?
I said the face off. How was it? Did you see anything in his eyes?
Yeah. He don't want to see me for real. He don't want to see me. See, what he do is he try to smile, but that's he nervous. He try to smile his way out of it. He nervous though. He be trembling.
You feel like you're getting played in this? Why? Adrien wants to talk to us.
So, I've been with you for a lot of fight camps, a lot of fight weeks, and you actually seem happy to me. Agitated, but happy. Like, maybe there's a chip on your shoulder this time. What is it different about this promotion? What is it that's going on with you emotionally when you're a little bit on edge, more so than usual?
I really wasn't on edge. It's just, you know, it is what it is. You know, I'm a realist, and I don't hold nothing back. I don't want to ever leave nowhere and be like, damn, I should have did this, or I should have said that, or I should have told somebody something that I wanted to tell somebody. So, you know, that's just it. That's just how I am.
You mentioned all the title fights, the champions that you faced, fight after fight, champion after champion. When you were up here, like, you felt disrespected by the size of the room, felt disrespected by where they put the media day.
It's cool. It's cool.
Do you feel like boxing's treated you well, that you've had your shots and your opportunities as you deserve them?
Man, I'm good, but at the end of the day, you know, I was, I'm from the streets, and a lot of people really don't respect nothing but violence and when you get shit done. So I just gotta get this done, and then after that, you know, everything gonna go my way.
Now, for two fighters who have 10 years apart age-wise, it seems odd to say that this fight kind of means the same to both. The winner of this fight, you know, goes on to face champions to possibly gain another title in the division, and the loser may be looked at as a journeyman or a gatekeeper at that point.
You really can't say that, because at the end of the day, Pacquiao got the whole Philippines with him. If he win or lose, he's lost plenty of times, and they all still with him. And everybody's still praising, you know. But for guys like me, they'll try to water me down. So that's why I am the way I am. You know, I never change for nobody. I don't give a fuck. So, you know, Saturday night, I will be victorious, and you're moving on up for me.
And lastly, I noticed that you talked a lot for this fight about your past and coming up as a kid and your relationship with Mike. Is this particular fight, if not more important, more significant to you as your story, as your legacy, as who you believe Adrien Broner to be? How significant is this particular moment in your career and this fight in particular?
This is a defining moment, and one of the biggest, going to be one of the biggest nights of my career. And, you know, I'm just taking advantage of it.
Thank you, Adrien. Appreciate the time. Radio Raheem with the problem.
Radio Raheem.
Adrien,
how do you feel there?